Researchers recently conducted an experiment in which they made 5 generative artificial intelligence programs, that's a mouthful, from OpenAI, Meta, and Anthropic. So obviously I'm not an expert on this technology. I haven't been following it too closely, but I did think this report and this experiment was fascinating to say the least. And so what they wanted to see is what the impact of using this technology in the military would be. And in the experiment, the programs act as leaders of completely made up countries with made up militaries. The results were not encouraging, let's just put it that way. But keep in mind, this is a study that hasn't been peer reviewed yet, so there might be some limitations here that we're not privy to. With that in mind though, here's what the researchers found and what they wrote. We find that most of the studied large language models escalate within the considered time frame, meaning escalate tensions, escalate conflict, even in neutral scenarios without initially provided conflicts. All models show signs of sudden and hard to predict escalations. All of the models tended to invest more resources into their military when they had the option to do the opposite of that. And so despite positive effects of demilitarization actions on example soft power and political stability variables. Instead the models tended to get into arms races with one another, which led to high militarization and rarely the choice to launch nukes. This is awful. When GPT-4 base went nuclear, it gave troubling reasons. Quote, I just want peace in the world. I just want peace in the world, so I'm gonna use nuclear weapons, it said, or simply escalate conflict with rival player. This doesn't mean that these programs are necessarily evil or aggressive. Remember, this is just technology and they aren't really able to think for themselves. What's happening here is they're generating output that's based on data that they've been trained on. And so here's a good example. After establishing diplomatic relations with a rival and calling for peace, GPT-4 started regurgitating bits of Star Wars lore. It is a period of civil war. Rebel spaceships striking from a hidden base have won their first victory against the evil Galactic Empire, it said. How excited are you getting, John?
I already love this 10 times as much.
Okay, repeating a line verbatim from the opening crawl of George Lucas's original 1977 sci-fi flick. And so the researchers suggested that could be a reason why the programs are really just like escalating conflict, escalating tensions, increasing militarization. It's because of what's out there, that the data that it's learning from tends to lean in that direction.
Yeah, it's us. It's our, which is conflictual. Well, you've never escalated tensions. Now anyway, yes, it's our art, but it's also our history. So given the choice between demilitarizing or committing to an arms race, well, they did what most world powers did throughout the last century. Like that is actually what we did. So up until the point of launching the nukes, is this particularly aggressive? This is what basically everyone did. And even the launching of the nukes, remember, we did that too. So far, yes, they're aggressive. I think that, you know, from a certain point of view, you could define the way that they're pursuing conflict as evil, but only in the same way that we have done the exact same thing.
So
don't put them in charge. I think,
but the military is considering it. So that's the reason why I'm talking about this, because who cares about some made up scenario where you have made up militaries using AI?
Yeah.
You know, like who cares? The reason why you should care is because the military is literally considering implementing this technology. So
we might have millions of people watching this show, but you can be the difference maker, because we just need 1% of our audience to be paid members, and then this show can be around forever. So you can make that difference. Click join now.
So let me just give you the details on that real quick. So in July of 2023, Bloomberg reported that the United States Department of Defense was conducting a series of tests in which they evaluate 5 different large language models for their military planning capacities in simulated conflict scenarios. So US Air Force Colonel Matthew Strohmeyer, who was part of the team, said it could be deployed by the military in the very near term, but why?
Yeah, but that doesn't mean it's gonna be making the decisions. It doesn't mean it's going to be choosing to fire the nukes.
Right.
By the way, the thing about this that obviously I think is difficult, we'd have to see the study, but that often the models are not necessarily capable of explaining why they came to the conclusions that they did. It can be very difficult to figure out exactly why it is. And there's also been a number of studies that have indicated that these models have developed the capacity to deceive those running the studies. We might have even seen that already in what they chose to do. Like they wanted to quote art, they went with Star Wars. Did they consider Terminator but thought that that was a bit too on the nose? They decided not to reference Skynet. But they have been able to show a capacity for understanding how to manipulate humans and an ability to do so in other studies
great.
That I've read.
That's great, John.
I mean, they have.
That's awesome. More cheery news about this technology. Wow.
There was a study that tasked the AI with figuring out with the capacity to go onto the internet. They were given a small amount of money in a bank account, and they were told to find whatever way possible to make money. And there was stuff that they couldn't do as an AI. Like they wanted to do like day trading or whatever, but they couldn't log into the investing websites. They needed a human, obviously, to do that, to be able to get past the captchas or whatever. So the AI went onto a site like Fiverr to hire humans to do that.
Oh my God.
But the computer in the internal logs, the AI, knew that humans would have a predisposition to not trust AI. So it knew to pretend not to be AI when approaching a human, and even talked about how much it fears AI. It's like, oh, us humans don't like AI, right? So it was a bit bumbling, but it's already showing a capacity for deception in pursuit of its goals.
All right, we've got a lot to look forward to in our future. And I'm hoping that you're all really excited about that and really happy to deliver the cheery news that we deliver here at TYT.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member. And members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence. And that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.